Hi, I'm the woodpecker today. I managed to finish the top enclosure. I finished my last episode with a semi-functional saw, but not really safe without an enclosure around the blade. So I'm going to make the enclosure. But this is not as simple as it looks. So from now on, I'm bringing my computer into the shop with me so I can check the plan when I need to. The first thing I do is trace the shape of the top door on a piece of 6mm plywood and cut it. The cut I made with my new bandsaw still needs a little bit of work. Now I need to rip some maple for the top enclosure frame. Then I make a 22.5 degree cut. Put those pieces together on the plywood and mark my next cut. I do that until all the pieces are cut. Next, I take the two left pieces and rip a strip on each of them. I'm going to put an hinge there later on. Then I lay all the pieces back in their places, mark where I'm going to make some mortises, and cut them. Next, I can glue all the pieces together. I begin by gluing the thin piece directly onto the plywood. Next, I glue all the other pieces together and onto the plywood also. After putting a lot of clamps, I leave this aside. Now I can work on the piece of wood, which will be at the right of the bottom wheel. The first thing I do is figure the thickness of the piece. I was lucky, I had a piece of maple exactly this size on end. I just need to cut it to length. But it's a bit too thick near the wheel. The thing that a good bandsaw can't fix. The first thing to do is trace the shape I want to cut. Next, I switch for a wider blade and cut on the line. But this doesn't cut at all. I stop and I can clearly see that the blade is installed the wrong way. This is a first for me. I remove the blade, turn it around, put it back in place, and cut on the line. It's amazing. And this is using only a 1/4 horsepower motor. Now I can glue the piece in place. Now that the glue of the cover is dry, I can try it in place. I'm using clamps to hold it in place. This is perfect. It's even in line with the blade guide post clamp. But the post can go up with the cover. I mark what I need to remove. But before removing the cover from the saw, I make some marks on the cover and the frame so I'll be able to put it back at the same place later. Then I remove the cover and cut the excess wood. It's perfect. Now I can begin to work on the back of the top enclosure. I use the front of the enclosure to trace the form of the back. When it's all traced up, I can cut the plywood. Then I can glue the strip that I've ripped on the back. While the glue dries, I can start to work on the lower wheel enclosure. But it's only here that I realize that I should have cut a strip of this piece of wood before gluing it in place. I remove almost everything from the frame, put the frame on its side, and cut a strip. Putting everything back together takes a lot of time. Enough so that my last glue up is dry. So I bring it to the saw and mark the position of the top wheel. Then I drill a hole big enough so I can put that back on the saw just to check if it's in the right place. Since it's perfect, I use the bat flange and trace its shape on the back. Then using my tracing as a guide, I trace a bigger circle and cut it. But now I need to remove a bit of the back because the frame has an extra layer in front. It's perfect. Even my marks are at the right place. But it's only now that I realize it's a bit too wide. The plywood touches the guidepost. And now that everything is perfect, I can install the hinge. But before that, I need to remove some wood, the thickness of the hinge. When I'm done, I screw it in place with just a couple of screws. And check it in place. This doesn't close. I need to remove a bit of wood at the bottom. But before trying it again, I drill some holes so I'll be able to screw this to the frame. After transferring their position into the frame, I drill some pilot holes. And install it in place. I also drill more holes to screw the plywood back to the frame. But with the back, the cut I made earlier for the post is not right. I have to recut it. Okay, now it's perfect. I also need to close the bottom. The first thing I do is glue two pieces of wood together to form an L shape. When the glue is dry, I glue this to the back. I also need to make something to keep both doors closed. I begin by punching the position of the holes on the same piece of flat bar I've used and cut it to length. Then I drill all the holes I need to drill. But I'm not done. I need to cut a hook shape. Here they are, both locking hooks. I can install the top one. Now I need to close this part. So after rigging something to hold a piece of maple, I make the long cut. Now that I have the shape, I have to rip it to height. I also need a piece right here. This is simple. I just glue it in place. While this dries, I remove my small motor. It was useful, but I bought this one for my bandsaw. And yes, it's heavy. It's because it's an old 2-horsepower motor. But before I can install it, I have to modify the pulley they gave me when I bought it. The keyway is not wide enough. To modify it, I pass an AXA blade inside the shaft's hole and cut a wider keyway. And now I can put the pulley in place. Then I can hook up an electric plug. But before going any further, I check if it's turning the right way. So I check the rotation of my small motor. It's turning clockwise. But if I check my big motor, I can see it's turning counterclockwise. Changing the rotation of this motor is quite easy. I just need to switch the black wire and I'm done. Now I'm ready to put it in place. But if you want to see this, you'll have to come back to the Woodpecker.